And this robot has two incubators, two units. One is a reagent unit. The reagent unit is a storage for reagent. Temperature is controlled always 4 degrees. And another incubator is a reaction unit. Reaction unit is for reactions for transcription, translation, and purification. And this robot has a dispenser. And after set up the all consumables and reagent, push the start button. And this robot is controlled through laptop. This laptop installed a dedicated software and installed a dedicated program. And the program is already optimized so that basically you don't need to change each parameter. After pushing the start button, robot starts the transcription process first. Robot transfers transcription reagent to the to a tube containing plasmid DNA to mix the each reagent and continue the transcription reaction. After 6 hours transcription reaction, a robot transfers transcription wrapper to a reaction arm. Then robot transfer wheat germ extract to messenger RNA to mix them, and then the mixture of messenger RNA with and wheat germ extract is going to be added under the transition buffer bottom of the cup to make a bilayer. Then after the translation for 15 degrees for 20 hours, robot add resin for the purification. This robot has a shaker so that the resin is shaken during the binding process. After the binding reaction, the reaction unit is killed so that the robot can insert a pipette tip into the nozzle and suction the liquid, which is a closed fraction. The frost fraction is going to be stored at 4 degrees. After the suction, the frost fraction, add wash buffer, then add the resin, suction, wash fraction, and then last, finally, add dilution buffer to edit the protein. The purified protein is stored at 4 degrees. And this robot can treat 6 samples for one run, so that they, you can get 6 different proteins per run. And if you choose another program for translation at 26 degrees for 8 hours, it takes about 23 hours, including transcription, translation, and purification, so that the next day, you can get the purified protein. It's very easy and very quick. You can save a labor cost. Mm-hmm. Next, I'm going to introduce this XE, the small robot. After preparation of the plasmid DNA, you should do transcription reaction by yourself, manually. The process is very easy. Simply mix each agent, SP6 protease, SP6 polymerase, RNA inhibitor, transcription buffer, and anything. And simply transfer the reagent into the incubator at 37 degrees for 6 hours or overnight. After the incubation, the mRNA, the white pellet is precipitated. So that to precipitate the white pellet, simply centrifuge the transcription reaction and recover the supernatant. And the mRNA is prepared into the, this part. And of course, you need to prepare the transition reaction, which contains a wheat germ extract and transition buffer. And you also need to prepare transition buffer here. And then this robot also controls through PC and have a dedicated software. And we made optimized software, so that basically you don't need to change the each parameter. Simply choose program as you want. After start the program, start the process for example, translation buffer exchange cycle, addition of the mRNA. The process may be complicated, but robot everything do that. So the people don't worry about that. This is a filter in the debug world. This is a filter the 5,000 delta break rate cutoff filter. So this filter, the translation buffer is exchanged. Robot has a pump unit. So moving part is only pump. So this robot is almost maintenance free, very easy to handle. And every consumer with this disposable, so that you can save a labor cost. And this robot can do only one sample for transition in one time, but this robot can produce 100 milligrams of protein. So if your requirement for protein yield is about, for example, 1 milligram or 2 milligram, I recommend this ET3. But if you need much more protein, for example, 10 milligram or 20 milligram or so, I recommend this